Hi friends, I am Sai Chaitanya. Welcome back to my channel Sai Tech. In this video, I'll be comparing the displays of the Samsung Galaxy M51 versus the Realme 7 5G device. So, which is also called as a Realme Q2 as well, which has a Dimensity 800U processor. So, in this video, let's compare friends IPS LCD panel versus a Super AMOLED panel plus display in the Samsung mobile phone. So, let's see which display is the better and how much the color difference will it be there between the both of the smartphones. And in case if you want to download this kind of good looking Spider-Man wallpaper for this punch old camera, make sure to check the links in description for even for this live wallpaper as well. There is a playlist available in the links below, so try to click that playlist and you'll find all the videos for all of the smartphones are separate in videos. So make sure to check the links for more interesting videos, friends. And let me quickly show you the model exactly. So as I said, this is a Dimensity 800U processor. As you can see, Realme Q2 or the Realme 7 5G device. So first, let's get started with the display specifications of this both the smartphones. So the display of this Realme phone is as a IPS LCD panel and 120Hz refresh rate. That is another advantage in this phone. And the Samsung phone doesn't have any kind of refresh rate. So the screen size is of 6.5 inches versus 6.7 inches. And Super AMOLED plus IPS LCD, and both are kind of same kind of resolution. And pixel density is slightly higher because of small screen size. And the Gorilla Glass 3 and the Gorilla Glass 5, I think so, should be 5 in this Realme phone. So overall, friends, on the paper, some people they do like the 120Hz refresh rate, and some people they do only like the screen quality. So it all depends upon the users, what type of user, are they gamer or are they normal entertainment type of users, or do they want small display or big display. So it's up to you to decide which phone you want. But in this video, I'll give you a quick conclusion at the end of the video, which phone looks better and why as well. So right now, as you can see, friends, I am playing the same video in both the phones side by side. So both phones there look kind of same if you watch in this video, but if you watch personally, you will definitely love the Samsung display only because of having the high saturation mode. So maybe you may not be noticing in this video, but as I said, if you watch personally, it looks better on the Samsung phone in terms of the very good colors of the sky or in the plants as well. This kind of region, which it looks very good and attractive on the Samsung display. So which is slightly saturated and the contrast levels are very high here, and which looks a complete white and close to the white colors and close to the realistic colors. Sometimes the IPS LCD is better in the realistic colors, but AMOLED panels are sometimes they are oversaturated and over contrast as well. So it all depends upon the type of user, as I said in the beginning of the video. So, but for me, I do love the only the AMOLED smartphones only. Definitely, I will always choose the AMOLED panels every time in my reviews when I compare with the IPS LCD panels. So, I decrease the brightness to 10. So, let's see in 10 brightness which phone will perform better. And both are doing very kind of good thing here. And the 5 brightness. Both are having the same kind of brightness level if you observe clearly. So both are having the really good images, but the Samsung phone has the advantage of having the bigger display, 6.7 inches. So which looks fantastic in while watching the videos. So definitely if you are like every kind of entertainment purpose user, then definitely you should choose the Samsung phone only right now, because this is the only phone which has 6.7 inches and Super AMOLED plus display within that price range below 25,000. So that's another advantage for the Samsung phone. Every time, you won't at all disappoint with the Samsung display at all, unless you are against the AMOLED panels. So that's it, friend. This is a quick comparison between the displays of the both the phones, and the final winner is a Samsung according to me, but it's up to you to choose which is the winner. And make sure to comment below which display you like and why you like as well. And thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Make sure to subscribe and bye.